Oh, hello. Hey everybody, it's Rowley. I'm doing this video because I say to Anne every time I buy one of my art books that I should do like a review for the group, but I never get around to doing it. So this is me doing a review of some art books. We're going to be looking at Sequoia by Tula Lote and Salome by Tula Lote as well. I can see that the text is reversed, that's not helpful. We're going to look at Badass Bitches, which is Meredith McLaren's new book. Walrus, which is an old Brandon Graham art book, which probably quite a few of you got. And also the signature art of Brian Selfries, which is massive hardback from Boom. So, let's get to it, yo! So, Sequoia is Tula Lote's most recent book that she released on her website. And it's a small thing. You can see it's a little bit sort of, you know, paperback bound, a little thing that she posted for like, you know, £1. But the cost of the book was £15. If you check her website or her Big Cartel store, then I think you can find it on there. But I just want to show you some of the pages first. She's got a really cool Jessica Jones and Judge Anderson right at the beginning. I put little thingies in to mark my place as well, because basically all the pages in these things are worth looking at. They're all really gorgeous. This is one of Pris from Blade Runner with a little mouse there as well. I think that's really cute. And this sort of Native American or witchy sort of Morrigan type character with a crow or raven on the side, that also looks really cool. I really like this one because I just think the action is captured really well, and it's just like a few simple lines of this lady putting on her shoes, which I think is really gorgeous. There's a really cool Electra and Jyn Erso from Rogue One. And one right at the back of this book, which I really likes the colours on. Actually, I think, you know, she tends to just use like really sparse colouring. It's just either one colour or it's, you know, two or three colours to sort of, you know, wash the image with. And the one on the on this side, I mean, I like the one on the that side as well, but just the sort of just the very delicate kind of detail that she's captured there in their dance is really sweet. So that's Sequoia, and I think, as I said, it's on her Big Cartel store, so you can check to see if that's still available. Next is Salome. This one came out before Sequoia, sort of same price, and it's a little bit more adult. So like the first, one of the first images is this. Are these very sort of tasteful shots of Tula Lote's, you know, sort of interest in softcore pornography, which is cool. She's got a lot of these sort of images of the woods as well, which kind of makes me think of like a Becky Cloonan image. But I think her and Becky are actually friends, so I guess that's not so odd. I really like this one on your right. I just think, again, like it's got that beautiful sort of, you know, two-tone sepia colour that she's done on the image, which is just really delicate. And the one on the left here, I think I just realised is maybe supposed to be Kelly Sue. It kind of looks like her. I think this one's really nice with the lighting as well. Got a kind of sort of Blade Runner-y aspect to it. There is actually another Blade Runner image in this book of the other replicant with the snake. I can't remember off the top of my head what her name is now. Is it Zoya? I can't remember. But or Zora maybe. But yeah, there's basically a lot more sort of adult content in this. Which is cool if you're into that sort of thing, and you know, don't get it if you're not into that sort of thing. But yeah, that's Salome. and I really enjoyed that one. This is Badass Bitches. This was a Kickstarter book that was done by Meredith McLaren. And if you don't know who she is, she did some recent issues of Gem and the Holograms, and she did the Hopeless Savages Zero book, which was the most recent Hopeless Savages, which was really good. I think she's done some other things. I can't remember off the top of my head right now what they are, but she's got a really unique art style, it's difficult to describe, so I'm just going to show you a couple of pictures. So Badass Bitches is in contrast to the one that she did before, which was a lot of men as sort of beasties and monsters, mythical monsters. But yeah, her art style is crazy. Like, she just uses a lot of very sort of jagged lines to achieve the shot. I can see that the paper is quite reflective, so I'm going to see if I can hold it very still for you. But yeah, it's like, she does a lot of mermaids, she does a lot of winged beasties in this. I think they look really gorgeous. The one on the left is especially really nice. I wonder if the image is going to reverse, so basically all the stuff that's on the left is going to be on the right. and so I think she plucked a lot of these from mythology. This one is Kitsune. And there's a really freakish Spider Woman on the right. So that looks cool. I really like this one. I don't know how to pronounce the name of the creature, because, well, you'll see it, and it's actually, the text will be reversed, so you won't actually be able to read it, but this is the one that I'm thinking of. And again, the lighting's not great, but and it's kind of reflecting there, but you can see sort of the kind of sort of lines that she's done on the wings, and it's just got a really nice kind of visual sort of skew to it, the way that it kind of goes up and then down. It kind of draws your perspective like that. And the fact that she hasn't really got a lower torso looks really cool as well. This one, Samadeva, is the creature, and it's just really beautiful white. Again, like, a bit difficult to see exactly, but it's just sort of really delicate colouring that she's got going on. And I think there was one last one that I wanted to show you. Shamaran, which is really sweet because of the sort of expression work that she's got between the lady and the snake, which is her tail. The other one looks like something out of a sort of live action or a Japanese anime, maybe. I don't know. Yeah, so that's Badass Bitches. Next is Brandon Graham's Walrus. Walrus has been out for probably quite a while, a number of years, I think. And I think it was certainly already out when I actually met Brandon Graham at an Image triple signing, which was like the first sort of comic, sort of, you know, celebrity appearance thing that I went to. He signed, he did a little image on the back for me, which was cute. I think it's the cat from King City. And basically Walrus is filled with doodles and images, and it's basically, it's like a sort of a visual diary for Brandon. There's tons of pictures of Marion in there, and sort of vistas from King City. There's loads of like pop culture references, things to do with Appleseed, Adam Warren's Dirty Pair. No, Adam Warren often draws a dirty pair, but he didn't invent the dirty pair. But yeah, there's like a whole comic where basically Brandon is a slug. It's just got loads of... It's just got loads of stuff. Pictures of Marion doing pictures of Brandon. and just loads of sort of pop culture references, images of Sexica from multiple warheads, and this kind of stuff that he would sort of print in, you know, he'd make prints of, or that would appear in Escalator, which is like his book of short stories. And there was, yeah, it's got this massive sort of kind of Brandon Graham, King City, Neo Tokyo kind of thing that he would do in there. It's also the kind of thing that you would have found like Seth do in the Bangkok Days, Tokyo Nights thing from Vertigo. That was really good. Yeah, and this really cool picture of Sexica from multiple warheads. So yeah, you can probably still buy that. There's a really cool pinup of Rogue, 80s Rogue, and Storm. Yeah, and I'm sure that you can probably still get this on Amazon. So it's not like limited edition or anything. And I think he's also bringing out a new art book this year. Maybe he's just done it, but yeah, I'll probably get that too. And the last one is the Brian Stelfreeze hardback from, yeah, it's from Boom Studios. This is a beast, and basically it's filled with sort of like process, it's filled with sort of other artists doing small write-ups on him. So like there's introductions, stuff from like, yeah, Doug Wagner, Kelly Hamner, Kerry Randolph, Devin Grayson, who he worked with on Matador, which was Wildstorm title. I'm just going to show you a couple of things, but basically the book is packed with his amazing artwork and pinups. And I just spotted a really cool thing which I hadn't seen, which is Matt Murdock and Natasha Romanoff. And Brian Stelfreeze is like, if you ever see any footage of him, he's like, he's just the most amazingly humble, clever guy. He's just really sweet, cool person. So this really cool image of Christian Bale. My shadow in the way. I've never actually met him. I know some of you have, which makes me kind of jealous. But of course, now that he's got this colossal fame from Black Panther, I'm sure that his commissions or his sketches are like super expensive now. So, but it's cool because he released this book. I want to show you that one. That's basically Emma Stone as Gwen Stacy, which I thought was just captured really well. I really liked the first Amazing Spider-Man. Didn't really massively care for the second one, but never mind. this is an amazing pin-up of Catwoman. With these ridiculous boots. Yes, I've forgotten about that one. That is an amazing image of Claire Danes from Romeo and Juliet. There's a really good one of Lilu from from Fifth Element. There's some really cool process shots from Domino, so the series that he did for Marvel in like 2003-2004 with Joe Pruitt, it's a 4-issue mini. It's really worth getting. I don't think they ever put it in a trade, but you can get it. It's like 4 issues. You can just get it online, and the artwork for it is amazing. But you know, I mean, everything that Brian Stelfreeze does is amazing. And it's got quite a few of those. I think it's got one for this Catwoman and Wonder Woman thing that he did for DC, which was like a serial in a sort of compendium that he did. And there's also stuff for Gun Candy and the Ride, which is the thing that he did for 12 Gauge Comics with a bunch of the other 12 Gauge art crew, which is now released by Image, and it's basically just Grindhouse. It's hilarious, sort of sexy, savage Grindhouse stuff, which I've actually got behind me. Yeah, and it's like two volumes, and basically it's just filth. I mean, Matt Fraction, for instance, describes it as violent, profane, sexy, and absolutely devoid of any redeeming moral or social value. So, yeah, but you should definitely check it out because it's just got these amazing action sequences from Stelfreeze. Some other artists contribute to it as well, like Cully Hamner and Doug Gregory Alexander and Jason Pearson and Rob Haynes and stuff like that. But it's glorious. Oh yeah, so this is some of the cover work that he did for Matador. So just very sort of simple, lots of silhouettes, blacks and whites, and just this great image here. And Matador was good anyway. Again, I don't think they released it as a trade, or if they did, I think they released it only as a trade in Spanish. But, you know, it's an old comic. You can get it on Wildstorm, so you can buy it online. It's six issues. It's good. It's a good comic. Really cool pin-up of Emma Frost. He does, like, some process shots on this image of Nicole Kidman, which kind of looks like it's from the Golden Compass, but I don't know really where that's from. And I really like this picture of Naomi Watts, who was Jet in the Tank Girl film, and was in Eastern Promises. And a whole bunch of other films. The one on the left, that's Lacey from The Ride and Gun Candy, who's completely, as Matt Fraction says, amoral and devoid of any redeeming value. And the last thing is a self-portrait they did, which is really good. So yeah, one day I would like to meet him, because he's absolutely one of my top artists. So yeah, the only other art book that I've got really is the Jim Marfood one, this is mental, this book. I mean, Jim Marfood is just an absolutely mental illustrator. I mean, most of you probably know his work already, but it's just packed with loads of spreads that he did, collages, just all sorts of crazy shit. And he took to, in the back of this book, he's taken to just basically painting on all these models that he gets into the studio. So he just hires all these girls to come in and then just paints all over their bodies. I seem to be like missing all these cool spreads that he did. I really like the colours on this one. So yeah, that's it for the art books. You should get some of them. See ya.